look at these two scenarios for a minute. Adam starts his project. He has a great idea. He starts by diving into Unity or Unreal. He grabs some pre-built geometry. He starts testing his prototype and he asks a colleague to check it out. That's a pretty general approach to creating VR worlds. I want you to think instead of this scenario. So Peter starts his VR project. He starts with a great idea. Then he starts by interviewing users and getting ideas from their problem space, from their real life experience. After looking at his data, he creates personas and a story arc, mapping out all the emotions the users will encounter. Next, he grabs some strings, some tape and paper, and starts mocking up affordances for his experience. Then he starts testing his prototype and asks 3 to 5 users he interviewed to play with his concept. He refines the prototype and asks them to keep providing feedback throughout. That's the new flow that will yield you much better results. And that brings together the difference between what you may have started with and where we are now. So let me give you a visual checklist. Let's start out with, as we begin to design, right? So we did a little user research, we brought in some real world ideas, and now we're sitting down ready to design. So first thing is scene approach. It's that first 30 seconds that are crucial. Feeling like you're there and immersion, deepening in. So that's the goal, that first 30 seconds, that's really what you wanna do. In a movie, you get like 15, 20 minutes, but hey, it's VR. So we think of it, that affordance canvas. So think of the affordances that you'll provide, the hints and tips that you may have around those. Think of the point of view that the user has to take. Will you give them first person or third person? Will you change that in order to change your story beat, your story flow, the emotion? Speaking of story beat and flow, remember that story arc, you know, where you start out introducing the scene, there's some conflict, there's some tension, and then there's the resolution. Think of playing with that as you develop a story flow, as the user goes through, and as you develop a story beat, those kind of actions and reactions, the way that the story responds to the user. And finally, there's the menus, right? So the menus, dialogues, are they going to be body locked, like where the user can pull them out? Or is it going to be world locked, where the menus are out in the world? Interactive visualizations might go in this too, where you've got a visualization, maybe you adjust it, turn it up, turn it down, reshuffle the data, whatever the case may be. Think about those emotions, sound, and movement, right? ESM, so the role of emotions and sound, and they build on each other, because sound can give you emotion, and movement can give you emotion as well. Sound and movement together, such as running away from a gremlin, can give you ESM. Remember, if you're doing social UIs, you've got social signifiers, the focus point where you bring people together, shared behaviors and tasks, and that feeling of being together in this virtual environment. Now, the first thing I want you to do when you're designing any kind of VR experience is to walk the scene. What do I mean by that? I mean, just get up and start physically walking around. Where is the user going to walk to? What is going to happen? Start imagining, and then you could even build in, you know, low tech, totally fine. Scissors, string, the kind of design thinking toolkit is what we use. But walking that scene, really critical. The physical space, the distance to objects and menus, what that's gonna be like. Are they gonna reach out? Is it gonna be here? Is it gonna be too weird? Are they gonna be looking down? All the menus gonna be down, 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 or the head looking down, down here, like I've seen in a lot of VR UIs. You can make a simulation of this, like a UI simulation. You can make a little video recording of all your flow sequences. Think of it like a storyboard that, you know, like a video storyboard. And walking and doing improv, so with your fellow designers, your fellow team, your content people. And as you demo, think about what all that requires, and because you're really looking for that comfort level as you deliver your content, you really want navigation and things like that to be secondary.